Alright guys, so I wasn't going to do a video today, but you're not going to believe what I just saw on my Instagram and YouTube feed. And it's basically this Instagram model. Apparently, from my research, she's a Brazilian butt model, as that's what she's been referred to as. Now, fake weight is the term that's been thrown around here. This is the term that everybody is branding this clip as. And I want to get the opinion of you, my viewers, just to see what you think of this situation, what you actually think is the scenario and what's actually going on here. So just to give you some context, we've got Omarisuf. He's renowned for mobility. He's renowned for knowing a lot about mobility, strength, powerlifting, weightlifting, whatever it is. He is pound for pound a very, very strong guy, and as a result of that, he's very recognized for it. He's held in really, really high regard. Obviously, he gives really solid advice. Everybody's seen him, everybody's heard of him, and for his weight, he is a very, very strong guy. So the lift that you're watching here, this is an older video of him, but he weighs 176 pounds in this video, and the squat he's going for here is 425 pounds. If you watch, the tempo's good, it's pretty normal. The bar looks like it's taking a bit of a beating from the weight, it's bending slightly. Does look perfectly normal, nothing looks suspicious in this clip whatsoever. Obviously his face is straining, you can see in his own words he said, the last rep was a do or die rep. And then here's the clip of Gracyanne Barbosa. So this is the Instagram model I was talking about. Bear in mind she's female. Now, I'm not being sexist or anything here. The reason this matters is obviously because people, you know, women have got lower levels of testosterone, and as a result, they've got lower levels of strength to what men would have at the same sort of body weight and with the same amount of training. So obviously she's female, she weighs 140 pounds in this clip from what I've heard and what I've read up about her, and she's about 5'9" in height. So this lift, when you add all the plates up, amasses to 495 pounds. Now look at her form. Her form is absolutely perfect. She's going straight to the floor, no issues whatsoever, going right the way down, ass to the grass, not an ounce of strain on her face whatsoever. She's literally lifting that like she could easily double that up and carry on going. She's doing 10 reps, literally like it's nothing. That would put her one rep max at 650 pounds. 650 pounds. Bearing in mind, she weighs 140 pounds. So that is literally like four times her body weight. Now, three times your body weight with a squat for a bloke is like quite impressive. That's like powerlifting elite standard. This girl is doing that nearly four times her body weight, and she's female. Like, what do you honestly think? I don't want to call anyone out. That's what I'm saying. I don't want to call anyone out. I personally think that this is not legit. I do not salute the fake weight situation, and I hope that this is not the case. When I was saying about Omarisuf's, you know, lift, his bar is bending on his third rep, you can see his face really straining, he's going red, he's trying, he's balls to the wall. That was a hard rep for him. He's fully kitted out in his powerlifting gear, he's got his powerlifting shoes on, you know, he's fully kitted out, he knows his stuff, and that is the style that he trains for. When you look at this girl, Gracyanne Barbosa is her name, she is, you can, when you look at her, you can see that she trains, maybe not in a bodybuilding style way, but she trains for hypertrophy, she trains for muscle gain. She does not look like the sort of person who trains for strength based on her physique. Like, you look at Omar's physique, he is in good shape, he is better physique than your average person. He doesn't have that popping bodybuilder look, because powerlifters generally don't. People that are that strong generally don't. And when you look at people like Bradley Martin, Simeon Panda, obviously they're genetic freaks. So that is a different scenario, but this is a female we're talking about here. So anyway, that's my opinion. I want to hear your opinions in the comments. I'm genuinely interested to see what you lot think. So bang a comment down below. Let me know what you guys think. But anyway, I had to get that out there because obviously I think this is absolutely ludicrous. We've seen things with like Rich Piana and people like that in the past, but women using fake weights, really? I mean, you know, it's setting a bad example. Let's be realistic. People do enough ripping off in the industry as it is. People sell bogus supplements enough as it is. People pretend not to be on steroids enough as it is and use Synthol and just generally mislead people. We don't need women using fake weights as well. I mean, men doing it, fair enough. It's an ego testosterone thing, you know, but when women start doing it as well, that's just adding more fuel to the fire. So like I said, let me know what you think, guys. I am genuinely interested to hear what your opinions are on this and whether you've, you know, followed her for a while or whatever. But with that said, I'll see you in the next one. Get them thinking I'm awesome. Man them approach with caution. True say we came with a bun some, but true say we came for the bun. That's some brown thing that I can put my paws on. Did you see what I done? Came in a black Benz, left in the white one. I'm just a